I'm Corbett Wall with DV Auction, here with your feeder flash for Wednesday, October the 10th, where this mud has taken over, guys. We have had so much moisture, primarily up through the middle part of the country here in the last couple of weeks. You know, before that, it was out east there from all the hurricanes of Florence that went through and covered pretty much the whole southeast and the eastern mid-Atlantic there. But now we've just seen just torrential rains up through the mid part of the country, and it's taken a toll on the demand for calves. Yearling demand is still good, but our calves are hitting town, and right as they're hitting town, the big bunches of them, we're seeing guys that just can't stand any more of them. There's a lot of deliveries, shipments of calves that were sold back this summer, earlier in the fall, on the big videos and in private treaty sales, and those cattle are shipping in, and with the feedlots and the preconditioned yards and guys taking those calves at the same time, they can't handle any more of them. This mud is just sapping them, and it's so hard to straighten cattle out in it. And like I talked on the previous visit, a lot of these calves have never seen weather like this. They're getting their first really jolt of cold weather, just like the guys that are taking care of them. You know, when you first get that first cold jolt, it's like your tunica dartis contracts real tight the first time, and the chills just go right through you, and you feel like you're miserable. Now, another 6 weeks down the road, you wouldn't even notice the weather like we've had the last couple of 3 weeks here, but it's really taking a toll. And now we've got this Hurricane Michael coming up on the Florida Panhandle. That's going to put even more rain out in there. Those calves are not feeling the best when they hit the sale barns, and then you get a shipment of those going out west, and then they land in mud out there, and it's really a recipe for disaster. We've got the El Nino year coming in here, and we're expecting kind of a rougher than normal winter in the southern plains, and the signs are kind of ripe for the Midwest to get a bad, cold, snowy winter this time, and guys are a little bit spooked right now. Even though they might demand the calves as a commodity, they need them for their program, but somebody's got to take care of those calves. And you overload your processing crews, your doctor and cowboys and things like that, and you're really going to run into a mess. But let's look at the board for Tuesday. October live cattle futures down 82 cents at 113.35. December down $1.10, 117.15. Not a lot of deliveries. We did have three tenders for delivery for the Kearney location in Nebraska. But anytime you start hearing rumors about that, or people saying that they're getting ready to deliver, that's going to make those longs, the longest of the longs, jump ship, which does straighten out the market, and it will help some of your hedged feeders there, but it's sure not going to help the board out for everybody that's just looking for the board to support the market. But October feeder cattle down 72 cents at 156.95. November down 92 at 157.50. Your fat cattle trade has been pretty much non-existent, which is kind of a good thing. You know, we the last few weeks we've seen the Northern Plains come in here and just kind of mess around and sell a little dab here and a little dab there, and it really kills the market for later in the week when guys are trying to get some leverage to hold the market together. But we've really only seen just a handful of sales in Iowa at 174, and that's not horrible. That's fairly close to last week. The Fed Cattle Exchange is offering 1,250 head on Wednesday morning here. Kind of see if we get the Packers to tip their hand at all on that deal. But box beef cutout values continue to kind of fade back a little bit on the choice anyway. But choice cuts on Tuesday afternoon, 202.85, down 36 cents. On Tuesday, actually, your select was up 91 cents at 192.72. Got a choice select spread just over $10. But not going to have a video for our Thursday visit, our normal Thursday visit. So if you can't find one here tomorrow, don't get excited. I'm going out to Virginia. Any of you guys out in that eastern part there around Virginia, I'm going to be at the BI's Virginia Herd Health Meeting in Madison, Virginia. Hope we have a good crowd out there. I'm going to speak to the guys about market conditions and different things out there, but looking forward to that. I've had that on my schedule for quite a while. It's just not going to allow for me to be able to get everything I need out there to get that done. It's an evening meeting, and I always told you guys I wouldn't suscept you to having to watch me do a cell phone video, and I'm going to stand with that. But let's look at your feeder cattle markets, your real-time index on Beef Market Central. 157 even, that's up 19 cents compared to Monday's close. Look at some sales on Tuesday there. OKC West, 1,500 head there. A much lighter test on calves. You know, I've been telling you that the calf run is going to outweigh the yearling run one of these days. Well, it's just too wet around there. I'm talking rain, lots of it. You know, Oklahoma City and places around there, you know, in the last several days, you wouldn't be nothing to have 3 to 5 inches of rain. You know, down in South Texas, they're just washing away down there. We've had a lot of rain up here, even in the Texas Panhandle. You go up into Kansas, a lot of rain. A friend of mine in my old stomping ground in Northwest Missouri say they've had 9 inches of rain on this last wet spell. They've had just rain. Everybody you talk to, my buddy Jim Felton up in Montana, he said it's wet up there. Just can't find a place where it's not sloppy and wet. But OKC West, like I said, had 1,500 heads. All I could say, it was lower on a light test, but not a good test yet. West Plains, Missouri, Ozarks Regional Stockyard. It can rain all at once there. They've got so much rocks, it just washes right over them. 3,500 head. The calves there, Dan Hill told me the calves were sure $3 to $6 lower, and all the discounts on the unweaned types, just like anywhere you go. But they had another big string of those yearlings from that Gardner outfit in Batesville, Arkansas. This is the third week in a row they've had multiple loads of yearling feeders there from there. And now 2 weeks ago, they're all weighing in the light nines. 2 weeks ago, they bring 146.75. Last week on the uptick, they bring 152. This week, they had 212 head of them, weighed 932 pounds, 147.75. So that's your test right there. They're $4 lower. And it's a bad deal because there's still a lot of demand for yearlings out there, but when you've got a lot of calves hitting the market and people are kind of standoffish on those, some of those are going to go into your feedlots, and it just kind of weighs on your yearling market too, weighing on everything. Phillips, South Dakota, 4,000 head plus there on their Tuesday sale. Calves there were kind of uneven, but they had a good calf sale. You look on Cattle Market Central, you look in the popular weight groups there, 1,250 head of 5-weight steer calves in Phillip. Average 550 at 174.94. Had about over 800 head of 600-weight steers, averaging 640 at 166.91 on the weighted average. Those 5 and 6 weight steers there, as far as on your Cattle Market Central report, look $5 to $6 lower. On your heifers, 5-weight heifers at 838 head of them, average 552 at 157.24. Those would be $4 to $5 lower. It's just this first cold snap in this wet conditions. No place to get those cattle in where they'll be comfortable to get them straightened out, to get them adapted to their new environment. Kingsville, Missouri, West Central Missouri, about 1,300 head there, had a good sale there, and you didn't see any weakness at all there. Look at this load, 68 head, 752-pound steers, bring 173. Wow. And then Imperial, Nebraska up there, you want a big calf quote, 61 head of 490-pound steer calves, bring 205. And that's your feeder flash for Wednesday.